I try as much as possible to encourage exploration and hacking and throwing a lot of spaghetti at the wall and then kind of seeing what underlying physics come out of that. We don't just make things randomly, but we go with hunches and then see if that hunch works and refine it.
Right, so it's not that it's smaller in this, it's odd that it's bigger.
Yeah,
I'm Dan Steingart. I'm an assistant professor in the Department of Mechanical and Aerospace Engineering and the Andlinger Center for Energy and the Environment. I study everything that has to do with a battery. Its materials, its packaging, its power electronics, and its failure. So my lab is set up to make new materials, put those new materials into batteries in various ways, because how you put the battery together matters a lot, make batteries of different sizes, test those batteries, beat them up, kill them, and then dissect them and look at them. And then we repeat the cycle again. If this is true, and R is constant, then PV over RT equals 1. The challenge in teaching, and I think that the benefit is structuring, right? So students' time is valuable. Students want to get a lot done, particularly Princeton students. But they also want to own things and truly understand things. And when you do it right, you structure a problem in such a way that when the student gets the answer right or sees the answer unfold either in their brain or in the paper, in the piece of paper in front of them, they have an aha moment and they take ownership of it.
Gamma ideal?
N over.
Which is TC over the difference.
I hope that the students take away an understanding of how to diagnose and fix complex systems. And something that my PhD advisor instilled in me, and I think is really important, is not to make the perfect the enemy of the good. So as Ivy League students, everyone tries to get the A or the A+. But when you're developing things and you want to introduce a product to the world has to have time to respond to that product, and you have to have time to respond to the world. And if you wait for perfection, you're never going to release anything. We make things, we break things, we study why they broke, and we try to make them better. And I try to make those cycles as tight as possible and codify that process. So if students can diagnose things, fix them, and make them better, and if they can simply do that when they leave my lab, I'm happy.
Dan wants us to be independent, and he also wants us to have the freedom to do what we want and to pursue what we're interested in. He'll try to point us in some direction, tell us a cool idea he has. If there's one thing that I would take away from working with him is that there's always a creative way to do things and a novel way to do things.
So Greg was saying that there's a lot of variability from the beginning.
Yeah.
So you should characterize that variability. So
Princeton allows for a lot of creativity. People generally don't think of engineers as creative people, but my colleagues and my students are among the most creative people I've ever met. And I've not seen a maximization of resources like this anywhere else I've been. I try to have my students leading the projects and looking at me like an old man that's behind the times by the time they're in their second or third year here. I want to be outdated and baggage by the time they leave. So if they're not teaching me things by the third or fourth year, I'm doing something wrong.